Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you here in the video lecture on the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 12 in the Module 1, Linear Programming Problem. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the integer programming branch and bound algorithm. In the earlier lecture also, we discussed the integer programming, we discussed the cutting plane algorithm and solved a problem in the cutting plane algorithm. So, here we will be discussing integer programming and we will solve problem in the branch and bound algorithm. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in integer programming using branch and bound algorithm. We take an example to understand the procedure to apply branch and bound algorithm. The problem: maximize z equal to 2x1 plus 2x2 subject to the constraints 5x1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 8, x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 4. The variables x1, x2 are greater than or equal to 0 and are integers. So, first step, we convert the problem into a standard problem. The standard form of IPP is obtained by adding the slack variable in the constraints and introducing the slack variable in the objective equation. So, the objective equation is maximize z equal to 2x1 plus 2x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 subject to the constraints 5x1 plus 3x2 plus s1 equal to 8, x1 plus 2x2 plus s2 equal to 4, x1 x2 are greater than or equal to 0 and integers. And S1, S2, the slack variables are greater than or equal to 0. The basic solution is shown here in the table. So, we have fixed X1 equal to 0 and X2 equal to 0. The solution is shown here. And here X1, X2 value, they take negative value in the Z equation. The solution is not optimum. We have to go for the second iteration. In the second iteration, first we have to identify the entering variable. The decision variable with the most negative value is the entering variable and the leaving variable is the lowest intercept. The leaving variable is S2. So, using the solution procedure, what we discussed earlier, we solve the problem. So, the calculating new Z equation, the new pivot equation and the S2 equation. So, the equation, the solution for the second iteration, Z equation 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 1, 4. S1 equation 0, 3.5, 0, 1, minus 1.5, 2. X2 equation 0, minus 0.5, 1, 0.5 and 2. The second iteration is also not optimum because we have X1 take the minus value, negative value in the Z equation. So, now this is the entering variable. And the leaving variable is S1. So, the pivot number is 3.5. Now, the third iteration, the solution for the third iteration shown here. The solution procedure we have already discussed in detail in the earlier lectures. In the earlier lectures, all the lectures, simplex method and dual simplex method, and in the previous lecture of integer programming, the same solution procedure repeatedly used. And the new solution, third iteration solution, Z equations 1, 0, 0. 0.29, 0.57, 4.57, x1 value, x1 equation 0, 1, 0, 0.29, minus 0.43, 0.57 and x2 equation, x2 row 0, 0, 1, minus of 0.14, 0.71 and 1.71. So, the solution is optimum. The x1, x2 value, there is no negative value, the solution is optimum, but it is not satisfying the condition. So, the x1, x2 values are positive, but they are not integer. So, the solution is x1 is 0.57 and x2 is 1.71, z value is 4.57. The decision variables are positive, but not integers. Now, we integerize the decision variables by branch and bound method. First, we integerize x1. So, branch and bound method to integerize x1. Now, x1 value, the x1 value is 0.57. which is less than 1. X1 is less than 1 and greater than 0. For an integer value of the solution, either X1 is less than or equal to 0 or greater than or equal to 1. So, the two restrictions are given. It gives the two sub problems. So, So the first problem, LP1, maximize Z equal to 2x1 plus 2x2 subject to the constraint 5x1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 8, x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 4, and x1 is less than or equal to 0. And another LP2, the second problem, maximize Z equal to 2x1 plus 2x2, the first two constraints 5x1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 8, x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 4, and x1 is greater than or equal to 1. Now the solution for the LP1, so the third equation is normalized, standardized by introducing the slack variable S3. So Z row value 1 minus 2 minus 2 0 0 0 1, S1 value 0 5 3 1 0 0 8, S2 equation 0 1 2 0 1 0 4, S3 value 0 1 0 0 0, S3 equal to 1 and solution equal to 0. Now the this is the leaving variable and x1 is the entering variable. S3 is the leaving variable now because intercept becomes 0. Now the second iteration, the value of the second iteration using the equation, solving by the normal conventional simplex method, the procedure what we discussed earlier for the simplest method, solving the equation. So Z row, new Z row will become 1, 0, minus 2, 0, 0, 2, 0. S1 row 0 0 3 1 3 minus 5 0 3, S2 row 0 0 2 0 1 minus 1 4, and X1 row 0 1 0 0 0 1 and 0. X1 equal to 0 now. Now this is again not optimum because X2 has the negative value. So now we identify the next iteration, identify the entering variable X2, which is with minus 2 value. And leaving variable is lowest intercept, so 4 divided by 2, which is 2. Now, the third iteration, solution for the third iteration, the Z equation 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 4, S1 equation 0, 0, 1, 0, minus of 1.5, minus of 3.5, 2. X2 equation 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0.5, minus 0, 0.5, 2, and X1 value, X1 equation 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, and 0. Now the solution is optimum. So the solution is X1 equal to 0, X2 equal to 2, and Z value equal to 4. This is the solution for the first problem, LP1. Now for LP2, the optimum solution for LP2, the basic equation, basic solution is given here. Z equation 1 minus 2 minus 2 0 0 0 0 and S1 row 0 5 3 1 0 0 8, S2 row 0 1 2 0 1 0 4 and S3 row 0 1 0 0 0 minus 1 and 1. Now identifying the entering variable, X1 is the entering variable with the minus 2 as the coefficient in the Z equation and the leaving variable is S3. Now calculating the second iteration for the LP2, Z row value 1, 0, minus 2, 0, 0, minus 2, 2 and S1 values 0, 0, 3, 1, 0, 5, 3 and S2 value 0, 0, 2, 0, 1, 1, 3. And X1 equation 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1 and 1. And here again, there is the X2 value, X2 variable, it takes negative value in the Z equation. Now, this is the entering variable, X2 is the entering variable and S1 is the leaving variable. Now, going for the third iteration, so the Z equation 1, 0, 0, 0, 0.66, 0, 0, 0.33, 4. X2 equation 0, 0, 1, 0, 0.33, 0, 1.67 and 1 and S2 equation 0, 0, 0, minus 0, 0.66, 0, minus 2.67 and 1 and X1 equation 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1 and 1. And this table is also optimum. The solutions are X1 equal to 1, X2 equal to 1 and Z equal to 4. So we obtained two equations, two optimum solutions, LP1, X1 equal to 0, X2 equal to 2 and Z equal to 4 and here the optimum solution is X1 equal to 1, X2 equal to 1 and Z equal to 4. So we have two optimum solutions for LP1 and LP2, both give the same value of Z value, so we can take any one for implementation. So So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book for your better preparation. There is one book, Operation Research. You can use it. I upload the video lectures in all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the branch and bound technique.